Almost 4 in 10 Europeans are affected by some kind of psychological illness. That's according to research from the European Neuropsychopharmacology Journal. Mental health disorders are Europe's largest healthcare challenge in the 21st century. That's according to the author of the study, Hans-Ulrich Fütchen. But despite this, many patients still face discrimination when seeking treatment, and above all, from society itself. The thing is, when you're walking down a busy shopping street on a Saturday afternoon, nobody will notice you. There's no indication that that lady, or that guy there, could be suffering from a mental health problem. They've no visible impediment. And some patients are known to disguise their illness, something that makes it even harder for them to be included in the hustle and bustle of normal life. Gábor Petri is a human rights officer at the Brussels branch of Mental Health Europe. He's highly concerned for the basic rights of mental health patients in Europe and feel that it's high time for both people and national governments to get serious about this hugely afflicted group in our society.
People with mental health problems are regarded in a very different way by the society than other disability groups. If we see a person in a wheelchair or a blind person maybe passing along the street, we feel sympathy, or we feel sorry for him or her, or we try to help him or her. At the same time, if we have a neighbor who hears voices, or who's got a bipolar disorder, or who's got any kind of psychiatric label, the first thing what we feel is not sympathy. We feel fear, and this is a big problem. This is why people with mental health problems are totally or almost totally excluded from the society. They have huge difficulties in leading their life in the community, and many times, and it's still very sadly is a practice in Europe, they are locked up in institutions or mental health hospitals. Estimations say that in the European Union there are more than 1 million people living in institutions still. These institutions are often found in very remote places, in the countryside, in Central Europe or in Eastern Europe. Typically they are placed in old castles, which are used for residential services nowadays. There are huge and grave shortcomings of these residential services. Usually policymakers and governments think that institutions are cheaper than community-based services. Whereas there are several empirical studies which show the contrary. Community-based services are not at all more expensive than institutions. So we would like to ask the governments to understand this and start working accordingly. Start closing down institutions and start developing community-based services, because in this way they don't only help people to remain humans, to be able to make their own decisions, to live a decent life in the community and to be the part of the community, which should be the right of all, but they would also probably save money. And in these times when everybody is talking about the financial crisis and how we should save money on this and that, I think this should be understood by all governments. Saving money doesn't equal with building up institutions. Developing community-based services is very beneficial for the society, and it can be also beneficial for the national budget.
And on that topic of the Eurozone debt crisis, according to the Greek Ministry of Health, the suicide rate in Greece has reached a pan-European high. The statistics startle Gábor.
We have recent reports from many countries, for instance from Greece, showing that the financial crisis hit so hard all sectors of life. People lost their jobs, people were not able to pay their mortgages, that actually the number of people suffering from mental health problems is on a rise. This is really worrying, especially if we look at the cutbacks of disability allowances, benefits, the cutbacks personal assistance received by people with mental health problems living in a community. Because we also have reports from many countries, even from countries which are regularly regarded as welfare states, such as Sweden, saying that people with severe disabilities or with severe mental health problems get less and less personal assistance hours from the municipality than they used to get. So I think we really should try to stop austerity measures and try to make governments understand that in case they take away money from existing services, problems will only be more severe in the future. And if we look at the rising number of people developing depression and other types of mental health problems in Greece, then the picture is actually very worrying.